Hello everyone, myself Ritika Thakur from BTech ECE second year, welcome you all. Institute of Engineering and Technology, Ayodhya, is one of the best engineering colleges in India. Under the kind guidance of our respected director and our honorable vice chancellor, our college has flourished a lot and will keep on moving till it achieves a great height.
Institute of Engineering and Technology was established in year 2000 by the then vice chancellor Professor Girish Chand Saxena, who made it as his brainchild. Now only after 17 years, Professor Manoj Dikshit sir is nursing this IET as his main institute by appointing full-time engineering domain director in IET. Now let's go around our institute to see the infrastructure and facilities of your own. Under building infrastructure, we have this first building, Visvesvaraya Bhavan, as Institute of Engineering and Technology started. Then we have another building, mechanical building, and that is Meghnath Saha Bhavan, which is having inbuilt Kalpana Chawla Sabhagar for the capacity of 125 students. Along with this, we have boys hostel, Saryu hostel and Locus hostel. For girls, we have Ahillyabai Holkar Chhatravas and Acharya Narendra Dev hostel situated in main university campus. Along with this, we have one international guest house, Sri Gendalal Dikshit Atithi Grah, which is catering to the education of IET. This is a smart classroom equipped with LCD display system. In this classroom, final year students come for presentation of their projects on state of art technology available on par with any other engineering college. This lab is research lab and used by final year students as well PG students. This lab is equipped with MATLAB and HFSS software funded by World Bank under TechIP3 scheme. This is Internet of Things Lab, Computer Networking Lab, Digital Image Processing Lab. Again, this is funded by World Bank under TechIP3 scheme. And in this lab, currently, students are working on IoT-based pollution meter and IoT-based smart camera. This is our Intellectual Property Facilitation Center. Now we have started final year engineering projects documentation and their innovations for intellectual property rights. This cell is first of its kind in Uttar Pradesh engineering colleges, which is motivating the students to go for innovations. This is lecture hall of IET. Like this, we have 34 lecture rooms and nearly 80 faculties are catering to the education of all IET students. Now with this, we are having capacity of taking admissions more than 500 students and thus needing the technical manpower need of our Hindi heartland. This is skill development and languages lab of IET. In this, students are given facility to improve their English language and also enhance their technical skill so that they become more employable as per the need of industry. This is first year physics lab in which students are able to perform physics experiments based on mechanical, optical and electrical, ranging from Kelly-Foster bridge to sonometer to optical fiber lab and torsion meter. This is mechanical engineering workshop practice lab for first year students. This lab is comprising of all lathe machines, hacksaw machines, cutters, shapers and milling machines.
It's been so many years. I still remember the year 2000 when this Institute of Engineering and Technology was established. And I also remember the first batch of IET. Your faces are still so fresh in my mind. Now you all are grown up, well established in your fields. But for me,
You all will be my loving students forever. To recall all those memories, we have decided to conduct an alumni meet in your city. Our first alumni meet was organized on 14th February 2019, but due to distance, it was not a successful one. So we have decided to conduct an alumni meet in your city. And I am very excited to meet you all in this alumni meet.
Yes, I am very happy that I have been teaching for almost 15 years. I joined at a time when good resources were not available, under the direction of the Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Manoj Dikshit and Director Professor Ramapati Mishra. New work done in IT, such as organize different workshop and seminar, faculty development program, national and international conference on different technologies, training and placement program. Students are placed in different government and private sector on repeated post to develop new infrastructure for IT, due to which IT no longer working with any NIIT. In such situation, our alumni meet with new student and new energy will be communicated.
In national level techno exhibition, we won first prize and the cash of 1 lakh rupees. Me and my team did a lot of hard work in this project along with the support of our VC sir, director sir and tech coordinator.
Other than those facilities, we have advanced library equipped with the facility of Wi-Fi to help students in their studies. Workshops, seminars and industrial visits are conducted on a regular basis to help improve our knowledge and give us a practical outlook of life. Art of Living is conducted every day to relieve us from the pressures of life. Sport activities are conducted regularly to keep us fit and healthy.
Our college has been converted into a clean campus, green campus. The entry of only electronic vehicles is allowed. No pollution or environmental hazards are allowed in this campus. The students are not allowed to smoke or cause any pollution in this campus. And we have also planted a lot of trees under the 9 crore program of Chief Minister, plantation of trees.
This is one small step in to the future of Engineering College at Ayodhya. We always knew that the alumni of this institution are spread far and wide all around the globe, but there was no platform to put them all together to make their efforts count towards their own alma mater. And today, with this organization of this function, I think we have covered a mile with a small step, baby step, but we look forward to many more such events in future in many more cities wherever we are. And we must be able to achieve the target of what we call as learn, earn and return. I'm thankful to all those who have made their efforts to make this event successful. Also thankful to the institution which has allowed us to host this function here. It's wonderful to see past students coming here, having a good time with us. And I look forward to their contribution, in a meaningful contribution, not necessarily monetary contribution, but definitely meaningful contribution for networking with the students of the present and also giving them all their advices and mentoring whenever and wherever they need it. I think we will continue to meet, organize such events, and look forward to all of you coming together in Ayodhya at any opportune time. We will be more than happy to welcome you all in Ayodhya.
So friends, I leave on to you to decide and rate our IIT Ayodhya. We all welcome your advice to fulfill our thirst of improvement, because where there is a skill, there is a way. Thank you. Jai Hind.